Alright, so here we are in a nighttime or twilight drive, the 71 Marquis Brougham. All the cars I have, I think this one would be the hardest one, honestly, for me to give up. Is it the best style, or the one that people are going to gravitate toward the most at car shows? Actually, this car does get quite a few looks at car shows, but maybe not. But in terms of just an overall driving experience, sitting in these twin comfort lounge seats, and this car only has 18,000 miles on it, I mean, it just is sublime. So quiet, you know, we're going 50 some miles an hour, just absolutely smooth. You can see the turn signal there. And it's just the most enjoyable ride. I mean, this is a terrible road that I'm turning onto here with tons of expansion joints, and you feel nothing, you hear nothing. Just doesn't get better than this. Nothing in the modern day really soaks up these roads like this, not even Mercedes or BMWs. The tire sidewalls are so thin now that they can't. This car just has 15-inch rims, so the sidewall, the tire is enormous. But just a wonderful driving machine. This car does have the 429 two-barrel V8 premium fuel, high compression. It has 320 gross horsepower. The four-barrel was 360 gross horsepower. And, you know, it'd be easy to put a four-barrel on, but I'm telling you, this two-barrel is very enjoyable. It actually feels peppier than the four-barrel Fords if you're just driving around town. And, yeah, it does lack a little top-end power, but it's no slouch. This car also does have the cross-country ride package, which was the firm ride package. It was originally from Alberta, and I bought it from a owner in Saskatchewan out in the prairies in Canada. Had it shipped to Toronto, where I then trailered it across the border and imported it to the U.S. So the gentleman's address that I bought it from, there was no address, actually. It was a series of meridian coordinates. That was his address. He was out on the prairies in Saskatchewan. So, obviously it wasn't used very much. It was owned by a farmer, and he drove his truck most of the time, and this was just kind of a Sunday car, if you will. And everything on this car is just about perfect. The interior is perfect. I mean, the steering wheel is perfect and beautiful. It has a rim blow. You pinch it and it honks. But this cross-country package actually handles decently well. And this is an enormous vehicle. Ford redid this platform in 69 and made it bigger. Mercury's gained an inch in wheelbase to 124. The Ford's gained 2 inches to 121-inch wheelbase. The Lincoln's gained an inch to 127. And I think, you know, 71 is just a great year for these cars. It's a relatively rare year for them. But these premium 429s and 460s were blueprinted, balanced, and, you know, the regular fuel 429s and 460s that came after them are smooth, but they aren't this smooth. This car, if it's tuned correctly, it almost feels like the engine, I mean, people always say it's so smooth, the engine doesn't even seem like it's running. It's absolutely true in this car. You really cannot discern the engine's running. You gotta listen really hard before you key the starter again, because you risk keying it when it's already running. And this car, fortunately, still has the factory single exhaust. You can't buy exhaust this quiet anymore, and it has no holes in it, and it's just absolutely silent. You hear nothing. I mean, all you hear from the engine is kind of a gentle whirring sound. You don't hear any rumble, nothing. No rumble at all inside this car. be sad one day when I have to replace that exhaust. What do you expect? The car's 51 years old now. Wonderfully cold air conditioning. It's a cold fall day here, so I don't need it. But something about Twilight drives these cars is just so relaxing. The green lighting of the instruments, the quietness, the smell in the air. This brings back great memories. The smell of the interior, even kind of the 50-year-old new car smell that this car still has, amazingly. Fall's my favorite time to drive these. Just everything is perfect. The only thing that I could complain about on this car really is, you know, the steering is still slow. It's a Ford steering gear, which they were slower. I prefer the GM and Chrysler steering gears. It's not bad though. It's not horrible. It's just, I think, 20-to-1 ratio. As opposed to GM, which was an average of around, it was a variable ratio gear, I think 15-to-17-to-1 or 14-to-17-to-1. Chrysler was 15-to-16-to-1, so this requires more spinning of the wheel. But you know, aside from that, maybe you detect in some of these Ford rear ends very slight whining at different speeds. I really have not detected whines in any GM rear differential that I've had. So, I mean, I'm nitpicking here. Really nitpicking. But other than that, nothing to really complain about. And this road is terrible, and it's barely upsetting the cabin. In any case, hope you enjoyed this brief video of a Twilight drive in the 71 Marquis Brougham. I have to say, if you get a chance, if you've been watching the channel, you know that Mercuries are my favorite. And I've got a 72 Continental. This car drives better than the 72 Continental. The Continental has lower miles than this. Not that the Continental drives poorly. I just think it's got too much weight, too much wheelbase. You go over some bad roads and you feel a little bit more bumps. Still very well isolated. But this car is just right. And the interior trim is so expensive. The Continental even has hard plastic on the door trim in some places. And there's not a piece of hard plastic on this entire door panel in this car. Just very rich and luxurious. 71 and 2 only, they would go to the Ford Common dashboard in 73, and the door panels weren't quite as nice then. In any case, thanks for watching. Hope you enjoyed. Until next time.